Hello, everyone, and welcome to the class. David A. Cox here with TechTalkAmerica.com, and today we're going over how to use Screen Splitter 2 for Final Cut Pro. Now, please, I apologize in advance if my voice sounds maybe a little bit funky. I am battling a bit of a cold. It's that time of year where, well, everyone here gets sick. So if you have already started playing with Final Cut Pro, and hopefully you've already taken our class, it's actually one of our top classes. If you haven't taken that, I'd probably stop at this point and go take that tutorial first. I'll create a link and put it for you in the description of the video. But once you start getting more and more comfortable with Final Cut Pro, you can start to add in special effects, and Screen Splitter 2 is certainly one of my favorites. And if you don't have it yet, I will again give you a link to where you can go to download it in the description of this video. Now, once you've downloaded it, this is basically what it looks like. They do give you a little RTF guide, but I find personally video tutorials to be a little bit easier. It's this file right here. You're just going to double click on it and just follow the instructions. Make sure you do not have Final Cut Pro open when you install this plugin, okay? So what this is going to basically do, I will show you right now. It is going to allow you to have multiple video files playing at the same time. And I find this to be especially cool if you sync those clips to the beat of the music. You'll see what I mean in just a moment. In fact, let's do it right now. So this is just something I kind of whipped up for you. The music that I have here is copyright-free music. If you ever need a resource for decent quality copyright-free music, I'm going to give you a link to that as well. You'll find that in the description. So let me just kind of show you what I was able to whip up here in just a matter of a couple of minutes. So here we go. Get the idea. So it's a pretty cool way that you can have multiple images playing at the same time and really any pattern. I mean, the fact that I have three little videos here, one that's extra wide, there's a million different combinations you could do to accomplish this. So I want to kind of reset this so I can show you how I made this all happen. It's actually pretty easy. There's definitely a little bit of playing that you have to do in order to find the right combo. I'm not especially talented when it comes to spatially figuring out, okay, this window takes up that much space, etc. But you'll kind of see what I mean as I go through this. So once you've installed the plugin into Final Cut Pro, it's going to show up here. This is the effects browser, this little icon right here. And you'll notice that in my little scroll bar here, it says My FCP Effects. And these are broken down into three different categories. We have Screen Splitter 2 with a black border. We have Screen Splitter 2 with no border. And eventually further down we have with a white border. And these come in all different shapes, and it kind of gives you a little bit of a, you know, sort of a preview of what it's going to ultimately look like. Now, in my opinion, I really like it so that the entire screen is ultimately video. I don't like to have a lot of gaps in there. So this is where it can definitely take a little bit of playing, but you might want to consider even sketching this out on paper, just so you kind of have an idea of your layout. And you can rearrange shots if you need to kind of crop it to focus on a specific area. I'll be sure to touch on how to do that as well. So let's do it. Let's kind of go over how to make this all happen. What I would do, so you have to layer your footage on top of each other. The order does not actually matter. When you're applying the effects, though, you do typically want to start with the top, okay, and then go to the bottom. So let's start with this one right here, okay? And I'm going to use this shot. I'm going to just, I'm going to keep it relatively simple. I'm going to probably actually just recreate something similar to what you just saw a moment ago. So I'm going to use this little border right here, and you'll see this is a 33 high by 100 wide. If you ever forget which one it is, I'll show you how to go back and find out. And all you're going to do is drag it and drop it on top of your clip. Okay, so now it's kind of bleeding through, and you can see the clip that's just beneath it, which is this clip right here. Don't worry so much just yet about the order of everything. For now, we just want to kind of apply the effects. So what I'm going to do now is for this next clip, let me kind of mix it up a little bit. I think I'll do this 50 high by 66 wide, and once again, I'm just going to drag it and drop it. Okay. Now, because I'm getting closer to the end here, kind of figuring out where everything's going to go, at this point, I actually am going to start to arrange these shots, just the beginning part, because this last shot, the boat that you see in the background there, is going to kind of go into this corner up here, and I want to make sure I get the right size to fit correctly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the first clip, which is this one, the wide image you see right here. And over here, okay, in our inspector, okay, for settings, you can see right here we have the information and it says position. And what's cool about this is it will automatically snap to the different locations where this can show up. So in this case, I'm going to do something towards the bottom. It looks like I probably, in retrospect, if you look here, I probably should have done something either a little bit wide, a little bit taller here, or a little bit taller here. So maybe I'll switch it up. Sometimes it's actually good to make mistakes because you can all learn from my mistakes. So it looks like I probably should have done 50 high and 100 wide instead of what I did. So what I'm going to do here is to remove it, just click on this little bar right here. Okay, see that right there? And just hit the delete key. Boom, effect is wiped out. Now take the correct effect and drag it and drop it back. And you can see now, okay, now it's going to look a little bit better. And now I have to apply my effect for that final shot. Now, I usually just kind of eyeball it, but let's scroll up here and see if we can find approximately the right dimensions. I'm going to go with maybe 50 high, 33 wide. Let's see if I'm right. Drag and drop. And what it's doing is it's kind of arranging the shot, so it's somewhere other than where it should be. Hey, there it is. Kind of cool, right? So let me show you a couple of the other little things here. So you can see here we do have an option to have the border or no border. You can see when I do that for that top left quadrant, kind of emphasizes it there. Border width, you can choose how thick or wide you want that to be. The color, if you don't want to be white or black, you can make it any color. Okay. Inside scale, this is just basically like how far zoomed in it's going to be. Okay. And inside position, this part can be a little bit tricky because you have to use X, Y coordinates. So what you have to do is really just kind of experiment. It's either going to be positive or negative. So like let's say I want this boat, it's kind of a little bit off center here. So in that case, if I remember correctly, and I was horrible at math as a kid, let's see. Nope, wrong direction. Okay, we wanted Y, or X rather. So I'm just going to type in a small number and just see if the shot kind of changes itself. 15 was a little bit too much. Let's try 10. Closer. 8. Okay, there we go. Looks pretty decent there. And that right there is really kind of, isn't that incredible how simple it is? A couple of the other things we have here. You can rotate the image within its little box here if you want to make everyone nauseous and ill. Identify color. Okay, this is just going to help you kind of see. If you look here, there's a little box for identify. And it's just saying, okay, this is what box we're working on right now. Something you'd only click on quickly. And then warning layer right here. Okay. Really don't really, I don't, I've never really needed to use it. And that right there is how you use Screen Splitter 2. So if I'm kind of dealing with this shot here, like if you look, see this shot here? It's just, it's not looking quite so hot. The action is going on a little bit further north. So I just, once again, I click on that clip down here so that it's highlighted. Go to inside position, and with that, we are dealing with y-axis. And let's try doing 25. Nope, wrong direction. Sorry, negative 25. Hey, how about that? Pretty cool, right? So that is Screen Splitter 2. It's really easy to use. Part of it is just really playing with it. But all of these tools are really all that you need to get moving with it. So again, if you don't have it yet, you'll find a link to it in the description of the video. Leave us some feedback in the comment section below. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.